Hello, singing friends. Welcome back to my channel. It's Miki here, your friendly neighborhood singing coach. Today, I'm going to be reacting to One Guy, 20 Voices. This is a video that was requested by my student, Owen. And I have seen some of these impression videos before, but I have not seen this one. So this is gonna be a first watch for me. And I'm always really blown away by these because I am not somebody that's good with accents. And I feel like this is on par with somebody that is good at imitating accents. You know, I can do a couple of accents badly, but I've never been somebody that's able to just hear somebody speak in a certain way and pick it up immediately. Of course, I can imitate certain singers that I love and I've listened to a bazillion times, but it's not something that comes super easily to me. And it helps me a lot in singing to figure out what they're doing technically. But I'm really curious to see how this guy's gonna pull off 20 voices. So let's jump in and watch it together, shall we?
Oh, Rumi and Black Griffin, this feud that you have going on, it's cute. I'm entertained, but I'm about to crash the party. You see, Joel, when you put out a challenge on the internet, there's no controlling who's gonna take it, and you know, I can't let it slip this time. This is a long time coming. You and I, we go back a long way, and today, I'm gonna steal your format. Now, I know you don't like when people copy you, which is ironic because the whole theme of these videos is copying other voices. So I'm gonna make things a little different. I'm gonna choose harder voices. My goal is to sound exactly like the original recording. So I got my producer, Joey, to make the instrumentals, and I'm gonna provide the vocals and the harmonies. And there's gonna be different types of reverb and different types of EQ, but there will be, under no circumstances, auto-tune or costumes. Let's go.
Okay, so just to start with, it's so funny. It just cut to a shot of him wearing a pirate costume, and I was gonna say he totally looks like a pirate. So he's very likable, very funny, and I appreciate his humor and his persona very much. Even before we get started, I already like him. Do you believe? I thought that was great. I can hear the difference between his voice and Freddie Mercury's, but it's pretty close. The one thing that I did notice, I mean, I thought he did an amazing job and he's clearly got a really, really cool voice. And I love that they're doing the whole track and really staying authentic to the whole vibe. You know, it's not just that he's imitating the voices. He had his producer make the instrumental and create the bed to really set the vibe for the song. So I think that's awesome. I did hear a little bit more of a clear delineation when he was switching gears from chest to head. So when he was crossing his bridge, I did hear that. And I feel like with Freddie Mercury, it was a little bit more effortless. There were a couple things that were like slightly a couple of cents off pitch wise, but I thought it was amazing. His voice is so, so, so cool. So I'd have to go back and listen to the original and really compare them A, B, but I think it's pretty close. So now let's listen to Michael Jackson. She was more like Beauty Queen. Really, really good too. And I love that he's like catching all of the breaths and the stops and the phrasing. I mean, that's not easy to do at all. I feel like he has a little bit more bassy overtones to his voice. So his voice sounds a little bit deeper than Michael Jackson's. Michael Jackson's was a little bit more high overtones, a little bit more high sounding. So there's a little bit of a difference to my ear, but it's pretty close. And he's doing an amazing job, not just with the singing, but with the performance too. It's really entertaining. All right, Kurt Cobain, here we go. Okay, so this is one of my favorite singers of all time, Kurt Cobain, and I hear the difference in this one because I've listened to Kurt Cobain so much. He was a little bit more pure screaming. I shouldn't say screamy because that implies that he's doing it in a not healthy way. It sounds like he's very much in control and doing it in a healthy way, but there was less tone in his scream than in Kurt Cobain's scream. Kurt Cobain was a master of really screaming in tune, and he didn't do it in a healthy way at all. And people will tell you that he destroyed his voice, and that's one of the reasons that he had such terrible stomach problems. But it did sound a little bit different than this, but very close. And I'm impressed that he can jump from style to style to style. Here comes Frank Sinatra.
I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my. So
again, I thought that he had a little bit more darkness or low overtones to his voice, a little bit more low resonance than Frank Sinatra, but very close.
I've become so numb. I can feel you there. Become so dumb. So much more aware.
Okay, I have to say that I don't know Linkin Park as well, but this sounds pretty close to me. So I couldn't really tell you the difference here. Exactly one Joji song, and it wasn't this one, but this sounds also pretty close to me. It's got that really, really nice light breathiness to it. Very, very beautiful control. Here comes Steven Tyler.
Dream on, dream on, dream on.
It's interesting. He has a little bit more bassiness to his voice than when I think of Steven Tyler, I think of it a little bit more bright, but the end scream was pretty spot on until the end when it felt like he was gonna die.
X gon' give it to you. Fuck waiting for you to get it on your own. X gon' deliver to you. Knock, knock, open up the door, it's real. The non-stop pop up for stainless steel.
Okay, I can't really speak to this one because I don't really know DMX. So. And I don't really know the Notorious B.I.G. either, so well enough to comment on it, but it sounds pretty awesome to me.
It was all a dream. I used to read Word Up magazine. Salt and pepper and Heavy D up in the limousine. Hanging pictures on my wall. Every Saturday, Rap Attack, Mr. Magic, Marley Marl. Out on bail for shattered jail, California dreaming. As soon as I step on the scene, I'm hearing Hoochie screaming. Feeding for money and alcohol. The life of a West Side player with count that and a strong ball.
Wish that I knew these better, but I can't really comment on Tupac.
Oh, ah, ah, ah. Get up, come on, get down with the sickness. Get up, come on, get down with the sickness. Get up, come on, get down with the sickness. Open up your hate and let it flow into me.
So I have to go back and listen to the original, but that sounded pretty accurate to me. And now he's going to do Enya. I can't believe the range of styles. It's quite amusing. Okay, obviously he had a little bit more bassy overtones there, but I thought the vibe was pretty accurate on that Enya.
The venom and living in other words, a minute, I'm gonna hurt him, but I didn't mean to federate your murder running in a body with a bit and finna kill him, but the fucking bodies in it like obliterating everything incinerate, running it and man and making a body who wanted with the penetrate, but don't nobody want it, but they're gonna get it anyways. I'm beginning to feel like a mentally ill, but tell a killer, be killing a killer, be the vanilla gorilla, you're bringing the killer with it, me, I don't
wanna be, you don't wanna be the enemy of the demon that went on me, being a receiving enemy with stupidity. It'd be every bit of me is the epitome of a spirit when I'm out of vicinity. Motherfucker, you better duck, you finna be dead, the minute you're an enemy. 100% of you is a fifth of a percent of me. About to fucking finish you, bitch, I'm unfadable. You wanna battle, I'm available. Blown up like an inflatable, I'm unabatable, I'm unavoidable, I'm unavailable, I'm unattainable. Got a trailer full of money and I'm painful, I'm not afraid to put them. Man, stop.
I think I would have to play that on 0.75 speed to even like understand what was going on. I mean, he did get a little bit of that nasal twang that Eminem has. I think that was pretty accurate. I'd have to A-B the two, but that sounded pretty accurate to me. Axl Rose, all right.
Take me down to the paradise city where the grass is green and the girls are pretty. Tell me, won't you please take me home?
All right, the how long was pretty accurate, and I really appreciate the harmonies.
Country roads, take me home to the place.
That, if I heard that on the radio, I probably would not have blinked an eye and not thought that it was John Denver. It was a little bit more strong and strident than the original, I believe. I'd have to A-B the two, but it sounded pretty close. All right, Chris Cornell, one of my favorite singers. Got that like nasal quality to it. I feel like Chris Cornell has more power to his voice because he just had an insane instrument, but that was pretty close. That definitely captured the essence of Chris Cornell.
My left stroke just went viral. Right stroke put little baby in the spiral. Soprano, see, we like to keep it on a high note. It's levels to it, you and I know. Bitch, be humble. Hold up, bitch, sit down.
Okay, you're seeing a huge hole in my music knowledge. I don't know any of the hip hop stuff, so I can't say that sounded convincing. Let's listen to some Post Malone.
Seasons change and our love went cold. Feed the flame cause we can't let go.
Oh my God. That was really funny with the auto-tune, I'm sorry.
But when we out of night, do the shit we like, we living for that. We living for that. Yeah.
Okay, I don't know who that was. That's my bad. It doesn't mean that they're not amazing, but I've never heard of Little Pitchy before. Okay. Heard that particular Vitus or Vitas song before. I've only heard the Fifth Element one, but that sounded pretty good to me. I'd have to A-B them, but sounded pretty accurate.
Love is our resistance. They'll keep us apart and they won't stop breaking us down. And only our lips must always be sealed.
Okay, again, a little bit too bassy. Matt Bellamy is a little bit more whiny and sobby sounding, much closer to a Tom York than this. So that one stood out a little bit as inaccurate to me. I'm sorry, I keep adjusting my camera. My camera is sinking. I have it propped on top of my computer right now. Stay.
Wise men say, only fools run.
That sounded pretty much like Elvis to me. It could have been a little bit more, I can't help, you know, a little bit more scoopy. But that was pretty close.
Okay, that's enough, everyone. Thank you so much for watching to the end, if you did. Joel, Rumi, now that I think I've topped you, I want to see you try to top me. I challenge you to do a video, two guys, 20 cups. I mean, two guys, 20 voices. And Gabriel Brown, Black Griffin, you're next. No, my beef is just with Rumi. Joel, I await your reply. Until next time, take...
Now I feel like I'm going to have to watch a Rumi video just to balance it out. But I thought that was great. He was really, really talented. And to be able to do so many different voices, so many different styles, and do them all quite well, and pretty close to the original. There were a lot that I didn't know in there, so I apologize for those. But the ones that I did know, I thought that they were very, very close and definitely better than I can do. I'm always amazed by people that can do imitations like this, and especially when it comes to singing. You're not just imitating an accent, you're doing all the technical stuff that the singer is doing themselves. So I thought that was really, really cool. Thank you, Owen, for recommending that I react to this. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys here. If this is Monday, I'll see you on Wednesday. If this is Wednesday, I'll see you on Monday. Until then, stay safe, stay well, and of course, happy singing.